We do a clip now up into the murky madness of the Bwlch Mountain. Now we shall see how many people have got their light on. And also the amount of people that haven't got their light on. And by the way folks, it looks a little bit murky on the camera. It looks a bit more murky in real life. I've seen the fog up here so thick that you can cut a hole in it with a knife, really. The wall that I built on the left there in 1976. A blazing hot summer. Couple of local inhabitants were there. Sheep. Last time we came up here, got some nice photos. Turn left towards my stake. Couple of the residents there. You can now turn left towards my stake or the Avon Valley. Or if you wanted to, you could have gone straight down here, down to Treorchy. Look at that brave sheep on the top of the mountain there. Cumbria and Beth. Cutting the scene is full of snow to it. Come up here one year, the car follows us up here with the snow blower. Can it pass? And I go on, mate, carry on. I got 14 foot of snow. Oh, I didn't realise it. What do you think we're up here with the snow blower for? It's not very nice, it's not a cake. Need to go back all along the other way. With the radio station up there, it's a big lay-by up there somewhere. Probably about another mile up something, I don't know. Been a while since we were up here last. We'd up here, me and a couple of my mates, we're building a wall. Boss said, don't go over the other side of the wall now, he said, it's a 200 foot drop. I said, what are you worried about? He said, I'm not going to jump off. He said, yeah, but he don't want to point the wall the other side. I said, why not? He always taught to point both sides of the wall. So I jumped over there, it was about 3 foot wide. He said, don't step back. I said, I'm not stupid. So while I was standing there looking at it, all these guys come up in cars parked in a little bit of a lay-by across the road for the radio station. All of a sudden, they started running across the road and woof, out of they went over the cliff. And I flipped it. Paragliders, they were hang gliding. Thank you for watching. I wish it happened about 30 years ago. I wish I had a camera like this then. I did have one, but it didn't take it to work. You go out there, you can see go there, and whoop, they were dropped down. All of a sudden, about 5-6 seconds later, back up they come. The thermals, you know, they would lift them back up. There's a lay-by there, I think. There's a lay-by, the other side of our wall there, it was pointing our wall. There was a lorry or something hit the wall and pushed the wall out, so we had to go and repair it. They were over the bank down by us somewhere. Just over the right by there. Just run across there and do it down where they went. Whoop, gone. I'd rather you than me. Now what a lot of people don't realise, there should be a marker along here somewhere. It's the highest point up here somewhere on the road. I think it's about 1850 feet. Now in the Guinness Book of Records it tells you it's the highest classified road in Wales. Up along here. It's the highest ARB class road. There used to be one of them round top stones, what do you call them? There's our benchmarks on them. There's a marker up here somewhere, 1850 feet above sea level it was. It probably been hit with a critter so many times over me, but it's probably gone from you.
That's new.
Yeah, no, I haven't noticed that before, that fence. Might be at the entrance to the radio station there. But there is it. Not the entrance, that's the entrance to the radio station thing there.
Did you see the stone marker that side?
Yeah.
Look,
yeah, no, you got it. Well, I think if I was up here, I'd have a yellow jacket on. I think if I was on a bike like that. Well, in this weather, you need to be seen, don't you?
Yeah.
You like with the lights on in the vehicle, eh? You see the lights coming over here? You could use a turnabout, don't you, I see? This is where West Glamorgan is from, yeah, now. You know what it says on the sign now? This is where the boundary used to be, there, big Glamorgan. There you are, see? Leith Portalva, see? Mm. We should turn around in the old road over there, see? In that old section over there.
Right.
Yeah, we should go back. A couple of times as I come up here, meet the other boys from West Glamorgan. You got a sharp, devious old bend there. You got a couple of devious characters in the van, yeah. Here we go. Sorry about the bounciness. You know, we're doing this on a photo camera video, like I say. Battery's flat in about 3 minutes. This will last. I haven't done a continuous video on it, but if I'm out all day, like when I've been in Scotland, I take 3 batteries out of me, and it lasts me about 4 hours, filming off and on. And I end up, when I go back, whatever, like in the on holidays, I got about 50 minutes of video on it. But this is designed for, but you can get the bigger batteries in this as well. These are 40 quid, these batteries, mate. In the shops, but you go on the internet, you can buy them for about 18 quid. 17, 18 pound, and you might have to pay about £2.50 carriage or something like that. Yeah, it's not bad, yeah, but you get 2 batteries in one. But the only trouble is the bigger batteries, they last about 4 hours. You've got to pay about 110 quid for them.
Yeah.
And if you go online, it's still about 85 quid, so I'm not saving a lot, right? Now it's a lot more clearer down here. Coming back down to the Avon Valley now, down towards, should be down Cymmag, in Corrib down here, isn't it? So this is your scenic tour for today by Mad Max 1 and my partner by here, Mad Max 2. Well, we got to be mad to come up here. I'm taking it back to Glanweed after the way. I like leaving a couple of comments. So they tell me you talk a lot when you're on the camera. Well, it's entertainment, isn't it? Who cares? Yeah. Yeah, you are.
Oh, you'll enjoy much.
That's it, yeah. Why not, eh? Why not, that's in it, eh? My arm down a bit. Stick my finger across the lens, really. Ah, you ought to come up here on a nice sunny day. I'll go for a walk if you want to. Look at the boy in there, isn't it?
So he's a funny colour animal.
Here we are, coming back down to a civilization. Got in there? Pony and trap. I haven't seen any yet. Then drop of water comes on that, oh, it's raining a bit. Here we are. Back down to the land of the living. Excuse the noise. Upper Quinby. 30 mile an hour, it says.
Doing less.
It's over 30 you caught on our camera. Or on this one. There you are, folks, that's the end of it. We shall come back soon. blind window over there. Yeah, this is the last row of houses up here with a bit.
Hmm?
I bet there's another old chapel of shit up there too. What do you think of it now? That's a big retaining wall there, mate.
Hmm.
When you think of it, probably could do with a bit of repair, that could. When you think of it. No mistiness across the valley, look. So just warm, see, innit? So just warm in the woods. Anyway, folks, that'll do for now. Bye now. Before we come down to this rather nasty bend. And here we are. A bit more of Abergwyn, be you?